Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today, I'm going to show you from our training a video and walk you through the Sculptra butt lift. Butt lifts are all the rage. It's one of the most searched aesthetic terms in the industry. And on Instagram and social media, of course, they're portrayed correctly and sometimes incorrectly, positionally, and there's a degree of dysmorphia with this. So it's a great topic. Let's go to the injections and we'll talk about it a little bit more now. Okay, so like every procedure, we're gonna cleanse the area. I mark out the patient so I know where I'm going to be injecting. I use this larger 60 ml syringe. For a lot of people, I think a 25 might be easier. We use it, depending on what we're doing, a 22 gauge cannula, 23 or even a 21 gauge needle. You want a longer needle because you want to, of course, reach the areas that we're trying to get. Here we're injecting, of course, in someone who's thin, kind of the upper pole. We're in the fat layer above the gluteus maximus. Of course, it's really important with anything. This isn't an instructional video. The anatomy, the concentrations, dilutions are important to know. But here I'm pushing the product in. I'm watching where it flows. Everyone wants to know about anesthesia here. And you can use topical, you can use vibration, but there's lidocaine in here, and that's what makes the biggest difference. Of course, lidocaine toxicity is important, so you really want to calculate this before, and you should be nowhere near those doses if mixed up properly. We often pre-mix it in an IV bag, and that's how we get our final dilutions. Here I'm injecting again in that upper pole, watching the fill. You can get a reticulated pattern and that's normal. It often scares people initially. This is during a training where we're doing this. So it's important to train on Sculptra for several hours, but also in this demo, all the trainees can see what it should look like, what's normal, what would be abnormal, and most importantly, what are the big pitfalls of this, because we want to do it safely. It does take a little while to inject this product. Some people use a stopcock in a larger IV bag, and that's another way to do it. And you can drip it in versus injecting. I like to inject it so we can precisely put it where people want it. Longevity, a lot of people ask about that. It's long lasting. We have patients now out 7 years. With this, it's not cheap. It's not a procedure that doesn't cost money, but you see the patient's thin. A lot of times people don't have fat to transfer, so this is their alternative. Their next alternative might be a buttock implant, and a lot of people like to avoid having those. Some countries, they're more common. A word of caution, know what you're getting injected, because there are bad things, bad polymers, fix-a-flat, silicon, PMMA, not Belafil PMMA, but other PMMA that are injected that are very cheap to do. So if the procedure is relatively inexpensive, there might be a good reason why that is, and you want to be cautious about it. Here I'm just repositioning, I'm injecting a little higher. Again, watching where the product flows. Sculptra, of course, goes in, it's diluted with the water, so gravity will take this down. The patient will have massage homework and a post-care regimen that's important to follow. And so we typically stay a little higher versus lower because of where we want the volume. You can inject laterally to create a little bit more hip. And often the people who are in shape have a hollow laterally and slightly medial that can also be filled. Of course, cellulite's a great treatment for Sculptra. It's done with an absolutely different technique, sometimes different dilutions, but it's often the gateway. People do the cellulite first because it's less expensive. They see what it can do, and then from there we do the buttock. You can add more whenever you want. So, well, after six weeks, we don't typically inject prior to 6 weeks, but a lot of people typically come back at 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 3 year, and they continue to add on to the result as they see the result and they want more, as finances allow, and for many different reasons. Sometimes cellulite can be treated and then new areas show up, and of course cellulite seems to be estrogen dependent and weight dependent, so if this fluctuates, people can want touch-ups. So it's typically not a one and done. Most Sculptra buttocks we do in 2 sessions. greater than 6 weeks apart. But they can be delayed by longer because, again, the PLLA is long lasting. They stopped the Sculptra trials in about 2 years, but the graft maintained the same, indicating the product lasts well beyond 2 years. And of course, our patients out 7 years, we have that data. Here I'm looking at projection, and we're discussing projection with the students so they get an idea of what I'm looking at when I'm filling and how high I want to stay, and the safe anatomy, of course, is very important. And you see, it's a little hard to push, and so there is some pressure involved. So those 25 syringes, although you'll need more, can be easier to use. There's very little bleeding. There will typically be bruising, so it's not something we want to do a week before someone goes on their Cancun vacation, but there's not a lot of bruising, but there is some. So that's the Sculptra butt lift. Join us on Instagram for more before and after pictures. It's a great procedure in those who are appropriate for it. The consult is important to look at to make sure you're a candidate. Join us on this YouTube channel and let us know what you think below and what's been your experience. Join us to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.